Welcome to the VEX-IQ Challenge referee training videos. Our sixth episode, Chapter 6, is all about scoring matches. A referee's most important job is to tally the scores correctly at the end of matches and hand them off to the official scorekeeper. Score sheets will be provided for your use at the event, and some events might even use the VEX Tournament Manager mobile app to allow for scoring on phones or tablets. All referees should be using the same scoring process, no matter which method your event is using. Note that although we will be mentioning the point values in this video, all that a referee needs to do is count up the various scoring scenarios and enter them on the score sheet or the app. As usual, the game manual is your best friend here. There are four ways to score in VIQC Squared Away: by scoring balls in a cube, scoring balls on a cube, scoring cubes in corner goals, and scoring cubes on platforms. Each ball scored in a cube is worth 1 point. For a ball to be scored as being inside of a cube, it must meet the following criteria. The ball must be at least partially within the three-dimensional volume defined by the outer edges of the cube structure, and the ball must not be contacting the floor outside of the cube. The portion of the floor which is outside of the cube is defined as a vertical projection of the cube onto the floor beneath the cube, regardless of the cube's orientation. This may sound a little confusing, so let's look at some examples. These balls would count as scored, as they are not touching the floor outside of the cube, and they are either fully or partially within the 3D volume of the cube. But it's important that referees know how to score game objects in these rare situations. In this case, all three balls would be considered scored. This is because all three balls are partially within the 3D volume of the cube. The cube is not flat on the floor, so the balls simply need to be within its vertical projection, regardless of the cube's orientation. One way to think about this is to imagine a bright light shining vertically down directly onto the cube. The shadow of that cube that is made on the floor is that vertical projection. Every ball scored on top of a cube is worth 2 points. For a ball to be scored on top of a cube, it must meet the following criteria. The ball must be at least partially above the side of the cube with crossbeams. The side of the cube with the crossbeams is the side which is furthest away from and roughly parallel to the floor. The ball is not contacting the floor. The ball is at least partially within the three-dimensional area defined by the infinite vertical projection of a cube when it is placed normal to the floor. Remember, if a ball meets both the criteria for being inside a cube and on top of a cube, then it counts as being on top of a cube. Again, let's look at some examples. Every ball scored in each of these situations would be considered as being scored on top of a cube, as they are all fully or partially within the vertical projection of the cube and not touching the floor. Both of these balls are fully within the vertical projection of the cube and neither are touching the floor. However, the cross beams of the cube are not on the side furthest from the floor. As a result, these balls would not be considered scored on a cube, but they would be still counted as scored in a cube. This all may sound a little bit confusing, but remember, the rules are just written the way that they are to handle the rare edge case scenarios. In the vast majority of scenarios, you'll be able to quickly look at it and determine if a ball is on, in, or nowhere near a cube. Next up is scoring cubes in corner goals. Each cube scored in a corner goal is worth 10 points. If any part of a cube is contacting a corner goal of the same color as that cube, then it should be counted as scored. The corner goal is defined as one of the 4 6-inch square goals located in the corners of the field. The inside edge of the black lines surrounding the corner goal mark the outer edges of the goal. The field perimeter and the black lines are not considered part of the corner goal. The cube in this particular example would not count as scored, as it is not actually contacting any part of the corner goal. Remember, the field perimeter and the black lines are not part of the goal. Also remember, only one cube may count for points per corner goal. Finally, cubes can also be scored on platforms for 20 points. For a cube to be scored on a platform, it must meet the following criteria. The cube must be contacting the platform, including its supporting structure. The cube must not be contacting the floor, the cube must not be contacting the field perimeter, and the cube must match the color of the platform. That is to say, it must be a green cube. This cube would still count as scored, as it actually meets all of the criteria to be scored on a platform. However, this cube would not count as scored, as it is in contact with the field perimeter. Just like corner goals, only one cube can be scored per platform. Now is a good time to mention that Rule G11 states that any scoring taking place after the match, due to robots continuing to drive, will not count. If any objects are to not be counted as a result of this, it should be explained to teams immediately. As mentioned in Chapter 1, make sure that you're doing this in a calm and friendly manner. You should explain why this is happening, and use it as a learning opportunity that the teams can keep in mind for future matches. Once the score is finalized, all you need to do is tap the submit button or turn your paper score sheet into the tournament manager operator for the event. If the schedule allows, it is also appropriate and recommended to confirm scores with teams prior to turning them in. The VIQC Challenge Game Manual, as always, is your best friend. If there's an answer you can't find in the game manual, check out the official Q&A on roboteventsfootball.com where you can ask a question if necessary. Well, that covers all of the ways that teams can score in VIQC Challenge Squared Away, which means that's all for Chapter 6. Thanks for watching, and make sure to check out the other videos in this series.